حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي ليس كمثله شيء، وهو السميع البصير المتعالي عن الشبيه والنذير. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون، صدق الله العظيم. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: المؤمن كيس فطن حذر، وكما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Respected brothers and sisters, first of all, we are thankful to the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah azza wa jal has given us the teachings of Islam. And the purpose of the teachings of Islam is to make an individual better in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which inevitably becomes better in the sight of individuals. Because the best system is a system that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And what is that system? That system is based on two things: Iman and A'mal al-Salih. What is Iman? Is to believe in Allah Azza wa Jal against what we see with our own eyesight. And A'mal al-Salih is something that to obey the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against our wishes and desires. If a person has an Iman which is not being defined by Allah, then his Iman is not accepted. Similarly, if a person does a righteous deed, he does a good deed, thinking of himself that he is doing a good deed, but eventually it will not be accepted in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because good deeds is not based on my ability or my authority or my definition. Good deeds is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us and Allah azza wa jal has ordered us. And keeping that in mind, my brothers and my sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this believer as a responsible individual. You are responsible for yourself, you are responsible for the people who are around you are responsible of your own family members, all of them, and you are responsible of your own community. And if you do some action that can jeopardize the responsibility or the security or the health of any individual, then that sin will come onto your shoulder whether you like it or not, whether it is according to your wish or not. And you know exactly what I'm referring to, that some people take this news and they make it as a fake news and they start moving around and do whatever they feel like doing. And then eventually, because of their action, others' health, others' security becomes jeopardized and their family security becomes jeopardized. That is not an action of a believer. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the riwayat of Musnad Abi Ya'la on the authority of Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, Al-mu'minu kayyisun. A believer, he is courteous, he is clever, he is understanding. Fatinun, he is very smart. Hadirun, he is cautious himself and he makes sure that others stay cautious and stay secure. And that's the quality of a believer that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave. Today, I think that if I do something good, which is according to my understanding, remember my brothers and my sisters, Allah will not judge you on your basis of righteousness. Allah will judge you on His basis of righteousness. If you are doing righteous, that has to be righteous in the accord of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what Amal al-Salih means, is to obey the commands of Allah against your desires, against your wishes, against your wants. Today we ask Allah for forgiveness, but unfortunately our mentality has developed some type of righteousness that I have to do this no matter what happens. Right? I have to do this no matter what happens. I have to come inside and pray my Jum'ah even if I don't have the right authority to do so, but I will do it, otherwise my righteousness will not come. That is not the criteria, my brothers and sisters. The criteria, it is fixed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why, no matter what condition or the problem that comes upon the Ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's obligations are such that can be fulfilled at any given time under any circumstances. I don't have to be at a certain place to obey the command of Allah. I don't have to be in a certain situation to obey the command of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you're not able to pray standing up, pray sitting down. If you can't pray sitting down, lie down and pray. If you can't sit lying down, then delay it until you have the health to stand up or even sit down or even lie down and pray. This is the commands of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that how to deal with whatever situation and condition that comes upon you. Don't force yourself into something just because of your own emotions. Because deen is not what I follow with my own emotions. Deen is what is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what is the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is a request that if you have symptoms, please do not expose yourself. If you are not registered, don't force yourself inside. Right? All of these criteria, they have been put forward for our own security. It's for our own safety. If the cases are going up and the recommendation is to stay home, stay home. If the recommendation is to go out with the mask, go out with the mask. If the recommendation is to do certain things in certain way, some people are still resisting to shake hands. They're still resisting. They think that if I don't shake my hand, then I'm not a Muslim. Unfortunately, that's not the case. Shaking hands is considered a mustahab act. And over here you are emphasizing, remember, let me tell you our fifth point, that when you emphasize on mustahab, that is a bid'ah. When you emphasize on something that is recommended, and you emphasize it to an extent that people think it's mandatory or it is important, then that itself is an innovation in Islam. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, which Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim has authenticated in their Sahihain, مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدٌّ. The person who innovates anything new in our religion, then he is not part of us. And that innovation will be rejected in this dunya, and that innovation will be rejected in the life of hereafter. We ask Allah to make us true believers. We ask Allah to make us among those people who are mindful of the orders of Allah and following directions. Because a believer always follows directions. A believer does not live on his own will. He is living on the will and on the decisions of Allah the Almighty and the sunnah of Habibullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah to make us among the righteous individuals. We ask Allah to make us among those who are vigilant, who are understanding their responsibility and who are fulfilling their responsibility in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the community itself. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'iril muslimin fastaghfiru innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من صلى وصام، وصل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من قعد وقام، وصل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وصحابة المقربين رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا معهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأعز وأجل وأهم. والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.